Only yesterday I saw her walking happily through the streets with her bridegroom, for today she would have had her nuptial festival. Every word of my neighbor was a dagger to my heart, and how often returned my torments, for each of my customers told me the story, one more frightfully than another, yet no one could tell it half so horribly as it had seemed to me. About midday, an officer of justice unexpectedly walked into my shop and asked me to clear it of the bystanders. "Señor Zaloukas," said he, showing me the articles I had lost, "belong these things to you?" I reflected whether I should not entirely disown them, but when I saw through the half-open door my landlord and several acquaintances who could readily testify against me, I determined not to make the matter worse by a falsehood and acknowledged the articles exhibited as my own. The officer told me to follow him and conducted me to a spacious building, which I soon recognized as the prison. Then, a little farther on, he showed me into an apartment. My situation was terrible, as I reflected on it in my solitude. The thought of having committed a murder, even against my wish, returned again and again. Moreover, I could not conceal from myself that the glance of the gold had dazzled my senses. Otherwise, I would not have fallen so blindly into the snare. 2 hours after my arrest, I was led from my chamber, and after descending several flights of stairs, entered a spacious saloon. Around a long table hung with black, were seated 12 men, mostly gray with age. Along the side of the room, benches were arranged on which were seated the first people of Florence.